Suppose we are given a right angle triangle A, B, and C. The side facing angle A is called small letter A. The side facing angle B is small letter B. While the side facing angle C is small letter C. Now, assuming that the angle of C is theta and B is right angled at this point. The side facing angle theta is called the opposite. While the longest side of this right angle triangle is called the hypotenuse, then the other side is called the adjacent. Now, in trigonometry, we are concerned with one type of triangle, which is the right angled triangle. And our focus will be on 6 parameters. What are the parameters? 3 angles and 3 sides. We are having angle A, angle B, and angle C. And the 3 sides are small letter A, small letter B, and small letter C. Now we can be given few of these parameters and we will be asked to find the other. How are we going to do it? This will be our focus in this topic. Now another thing I want us to know is that we can be asked to find sine theta or cos theta or tan theta. How do we look for these things? This will also be our focus in this topic. Now I want you to know that there's a formula that simplifies all of those. What is the formula? Socatoire. The so simply means what? Sine equal to opposite over hypotenuse. The ka, which is the black, means cosine equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. Then the toa, which is the blue, means tangent equal to opposite over adjacent. Now we are going to use these 3 things to illustrate what we are going to do throughout trigonometry. Please know this acronym, SOCATOIR: sine equal to opposite over hypotenuse, cosine, which is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, and the tangent, which is equal to opposite over adjacent. So simply means opposite over hypotenuse, and from this diagram it is C over B. The opposite is C and the hypotenuse is B. Now let's look at the ka, that is the black. Ka simply means cosine equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. And the adjacent, based on this diagram, is A. The hypotenuse is B. So it is cosine theta equal to A over B. Then the last one, which is the tangent. The meaning of tangent of toa simply means the tangent or the tan equal to opposite over adjacent. Okay, tangent theta equal to opposite over adjacent. The opposite here is our small letter C, then the adjacent is what? Our small letter A. So we are having SOCATOIR. That is how we illustrate this basically. Let's take this relevant example. Given that sine theta is equal to 8 over 17, we are asked to calculate the values of number 1, cos theta, number 2, tan theta, and number 3, cos theta plus sine theta all over cos theta minus sine theta. In solving this problem, we are going to apply the method SOCATOIR. Okay, sine theta is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, which is 8 over 17 as we are given. Okay, now let us see how we can represent this in a triangle. This is a right angle triangle. Okay, a right angle triangle, and it is right angled at this point. This right angle triangle is right angled at this point here. So since it is right angled at this point, now let us take this part to be our theta. Let this place be our theta. I want us to know that since here is the theta, the place facing theta is called our opposite. This part facing theta is called our opposite, and it is 8. Since opposite is 8, this part will be 8. Okay, then the longest side of a triangle, which is the hypotenuse, is equal to 17 as we are given. Hypotenuse is 17. Then the other side is called the adjacent. Now let us see, given these parameters, let's see how we can solve for cos theta. In order for us to find cos theta, now the formula for cos, we are going to apply the car, okay, which is cos theta equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent over hypotenuse. Okay, now what is our adjacent? Adjacent, based on this right angle triangle, this point is our adjacent, which is unknown. Okay, it is our adjacent, which is unknown. Now our hypotenuse will be the longest side of the right angle triangle, which is 17. Okay, our hypotenuse is 17. Now how do we get cos theta? We will not be able to get cos theta because our adjacent is not known. We need to solve for our adjacent first before we can substitute to solve for our cos theta. Now how do we get our adjacent? Since we are having a right angle triangle this way and the opposite hypotenuse are known, so to solve for the adjacent, we apply Pythagoras theorem. Now how do we apply Pythagoras theorem? What does the Pythagoras theorem state? Pythagoras theorem states that if we are looking for the hypotenuse is equal to the opposite square of the opposite plus the square of the adjacent. Okay, now how do we get the adjacent which we are looking for? We make adjacent the subject of formula here. To solve for the adjacent, we make the adjacent here the subject of the formula. Now making this the subject of formula, it simply means allowing the adjacent to stand alone. So if this is standing alone, that means our opposite is going to go to the left hand side. So if opposite is moving to the left hand side, the sign here will change. So instead of positive opposite, it becomes negative. Okay, so we are having hypotenuse squared minus opposite squared equal to our adjacent squared. Now we are going to substitute. Our hypotenuse is equal to 17, our opposite is equal to 8. Okay, so 17 squared is 289, 8 squared is 64. So if you subtract these two, you are going to have 225 is equal to adjacent squared. To find adjacent, we find the square root of both sides. Okay, so square root of 225 is equal to 15, and square root of adjacent squared is equal to adjacent. So we have gotten the adjacent to be 15. Now we are going to substitute. Anywhere we see adjacent, we replace it with 15, which is equal to 15 over 17. Now the second problem, we are asked to find tan theta. How do we solve for tan theta? We all know that tan is equal to what? It's equal to opposite over adjacent. and our opposite is equal to 8, okay? Opposite is equal to 8, all over our adjacent has been found, which is 15. So 8 over 15. Now the third one says we should find cos theta plus sine theta all over cos theta minus sine theta. Can you pause the video and try to solve the problem? So cos theta is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, which is equal to 15 over 17. Then our sine theta is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, which is equal to 8 over 17. So since we've gotten our parameters, we have to substitute into this equation. We are going to substitute. So anywhere we see cos theta, we put 15 over 17. Wherever we see sine theta, we put 8 over 17. So we are having 15 over 17 plus 8 over 17 all divided by 15 over 17 minus 8 over 17. Now we are going to simplify this to solve. Since the denominators are the same, so we are just going to add the numerator, which is 15 plus 8. So 15 plus 8, we are going to get 23 over 17. 23 over 17. We are also going to subtract the numerator here since the denominators are the same. So it becomes 15 minus 8, which is 7. Okay. So if I want to change the division sign to multiplication, I find the inverse. So 17 will come up and 7 will come down. So it becomes 23 over 17 times 17 over 7. So 17 cancel out 17. So the answer will be 23 over 7. So this is the answer to this problem, 23 over 7.